would you want your last meal to be?
Pizza.
What two things would you bring to a deserted island?
This is a morbid question. A boat and another boat.
If you weren't an actor, what would you be?
An astronaut.
Actor was easier than astronaut, but harder than a lot else. Or they could just, if they're watching NASA, you can just send me up anytime. I'm pretty smart. Hamlet in space. I mean, space Hamlet.
Sign me up.
Yeah, I'm watching that.
I'm in.
It's crazy if you don't.
Matthew, what is your favorite animal after cows? If anybody goes and looks
like
at your
cows.
Instagram account, you're a big animal lover.
Yes.
In general, there are a lot of animal pics up there.
No, yeah. Just for the future, it's going to continue to dominate my sort of social media space, just so people are aware. But my second favorite animal, you know, you can't really. I like owls. They don't like me, but I like owls. I like llamas. All kinds of animals.
Those are good choices. Why cows? Why are they so near and dear to you?
I don't know. They're friendly. They seem sweet. I mean, cows, everyone likes it. Who doesn't like cows? That's madness. I think we should provide more showers for cows.
Okay.
There's a business in that somewhere.
Wise words from Matthew Daddario.
Hey, Valentine. I hope you get a big kiss from a train, a fast train. Love you, Alec. That good? That passive aggressive? Or is that pretty aggressive? Screw you, Valentine.
And how long did it take you to get used to having the runes applied every day?
Oh man, you still don't get used to it. They're easy to have on, but it becomes a little bit of a, I want to get them off.
Do you ever try to ask for them to put you in long sleeves so you don't have to have as many?
No, I would never do that.
Texting or Googling? Like,
You're
always on your phone.
Always on the phone talking to people.
I do talk to my family a lot.
Source of information.
Yeah, and he gives us information.
Yeah, the amount of times I've heard Matt look at his phone for 4 or 5 minutes and we change subjects and he goes, oh, this is fascinating. This is fascinating.
Far across the distance and spaces between us,
no sunshine part, just that. And no sunshine, and then that would be it. And then she'd say it over and over.
I think you just got Matt Daddario singing as well.
That was.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna either reblog, like, or block the various posts that we read off of this machine here. First one. When birds bob their head, like they're really into your conversation, reblog if you agree. This is not a complete thought.
I just liked it.
But do I have to reblog it?
I don't understand what the sentence means.
I'm gonna go with just this.
I know, I like that. I like birds.
Last night I dreamt there was like a new meme slang and it was bode. As in like bodacious. So like people would zoom in on pics of really fat cats and it would just say bode.
I need to see more bodacious cats.
I need, yeah, exactly. Oh, there we go.
Bode.
So just fat cats?
Alright, so that works. Yeah, I'm gonna reblog
definitely.
Cats. Bodacious cats. You kidding me?
Whoa.
Okay, this has cursing in it. You gonna bleep this?
It's good.
Alec is so f***ing hardcore. Never kissed anyone before, so naturally he grabs the I Warlock of Brooklyn by the lapels and kisses him in front of every single person that matters to him in his own wedding with another person after telling his own mom off? And then he goes straight in for more? Alec Lightwood is wild as hell.
Hell yeah.
I was allowed to curse there.
I like that. I do not watch this shadow hunting show. All I know is that tall, dark, and handsome deserves to marry Mike from Glee.
I like it. Oh boy. And Simon should be your number one guy.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
You should.
New Year's resolution for you to be number one. Thanks, guys.
It's not a resolution.
Oh, it's...
smile.
Thank you.
Hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, hello. Look at this. Okay, how do I respond? I can't respond. I don't know how to do that. That's something dangerous. I'm not supposed to position myself. You know, I haven't really quite figured this out. Since you guys always make fun of me for it, I enjoy doing it. I'm going to press the button. Here we go. It's not a button. Ah, there it is. Now it's a button.
Swipe down, double tap to flip. Okay, oops. There it is. Hang off now. I'm doing the thing. Oh, no, I'm not.
Ah, okay. All right, I'm pressing the button. Beep. Beep.
See, what are all these hearts that float along the bottom? Something weird about that. All right, I gotta go. So, bye-bye. I'm pressing finish. This is so terrible.
All right, we'll miss you too. Bye-bye.
Thank you, guys.
I'm pressing finish.
Yes.
My connection is what? You guys have to learn not to curse on this thing. This is a public thing. You can't curse here. And there's kids here, guys. Put... You guys. You guys. This is so bad. Hey, you. Hey. You don't say that. That's not nice. Oh, that's inappropriate. Okay. You know... Alright. I'm a dork. You guys keep calling me a dork. It's kind of a bummer. Hey, that's inappropriate. You don't say inappropriate things on here. Come on, guys. That's not nice.
Such a tease you are, Matthew. That's not very nice.
I don't know about that.
Are you making fun of me? You call me another one of these mean things you guys call me?
If people are mean to you, don't be mean back. Just ignore them.
I appreciate that.
And that's your mother talking. I'm your mother, and I'm telling you to ignore the people who are mean to you.
You should always listen to this guy.
Yeah.
He gives great advice.
Does he?
He does.
Oh, I don't listen to me, so I don't know.
Well, you should.
I think that it's important sometimes to look at relationships for their how they bond and how they understand each other and work with each other. Because really, you know, the sexual aspect and all those kind of things, those are only parts of relationships, and everything else builds to that. Romance is a result of a mutual understanding of each other and a mutual respect. What do you got me doing? I'm talking like, what am I talking about? Am I philosophizing right now? Is that even a word? What is the point of this? I think I'm tired. Everyone's very, very supportive and enthusiastic, and I appreciate that. And those who are not are those who have generally seem to be prone to outrage are often people, sometimes I look, people who are very angry. I think we all need to sort of sometimes take a step back, review what it is we're upset about, and try to come to a more understanding, rational position where we view other people as presumed equals, and then we go from there. You got to call people you love, everyone, and you got to tell them. Because Valentine's Day is not just about romantic love and from a commercial standpoint. It's really about removing yourself from apathy and loving all things and everything you love. And those are the things that people love about each other. Those little subtle things, you know, these little things. It's not the grand moments of this or that. It's the things that they do every day that make you feel connected to them. And those are the things that you should focus on Valentine's Day, which is today. Now, I said earlier that this holiday is about love or the rejection of apathy or whatever nonsense I was coming up with. It's actually about candy now.
You always have to love your mother. Always. I love your mom. But you're allowed to fight with family members. In fact, that's one of the great things about family members is that they're always your family members until they're not. But don't try to figure that one out. I didn't know where I was going with that.
Matt, can you not tell everyone things that you're not supposed to tell them. Oh boy. Someone's saying I'm being salty right now. Am I being salty? Do I seem tired? I think I'm probably tired. I know your game. I know your game. Okay, here she comes. Should we let her in? Let's play a trick on her. Oh, you guys can't do anything. Yeah, come on in. Today's Valentine's Day. I'm not going to die from eating candy. People now get on my case for eating candy. You know, you can't all be my parents. Your connection is so bad, how sad. That rhymes, that's nice. I want to go fishing. I want to go fishing. I do. I want to go fishing. I want to catch a big old fish. I want to put him back in the water so he can swim off like a little fishy. Yeah. Today is National Women's Day, so shout out to all the women out there. My mother, my sisters, all great people who raised me and made me the person I am today. And honestly, my mom's like the most impressive lady of all time. My mom's more impressive than your mom. I'm kidding, your moms are all great. And go tell your mother you love her. Or at least think about your mother if she's not available. People are saying they're not in high school. Some are saying they're in college. Some are saying that they're university students. Some are saying they're in kindergarten. Some are saying they're 143. Which seems unlikely. Can you touch my hair? If you see me and you ask politely, I may let you. I don't know why you'd want to. We can do what we want, Matthew. Yes, you can. You can do whatever you want. You do what you want.
I have a scene with Alberto.
With Alberto?
Mm-hmm.
What could she be doing with Alberto? Because you're off doing that thing with the thing and that special
and
thing
people.
And those people. Oh my good lord.
And the other thing with the other special thing. Oh, really lord. Special thing in 16.
That's, oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you guys are going to love that.
Mm-hmm.
That's fun. I like that. So I'm only going to be able to do this for about 10 minutes. But luckily I kept my clothes on, which is good. I'm so old. I don't remember my first date. I'm sure it went splendidly. My sisters could pop on Shadowhunters. That would be amusing. Can you imagine? You write, Matt. You write. I don't know what about. What I do. And honestly, I think they were doing some loving. Wink, wink. I don't have a kitten. Wow, this is so fast. Look at what the phone does to distort the edge of your face. Whoa, my head's big. That's my phone camera, I think. I don't know. I'm not gonna take off my shirt. Come on. Come on. Come on. That's not fair. I can't do it. If you could time travel. Time travel's a diffy subject because I mean there's all these places I go back and I'd probably get killed. Or I'd die of disease. I mean, that's kind of tough. But if I was guaranteed that I wouldn't, I'd just a whole tour. I recently was reading about a battle. Oh God, the Romans and he made his way into Spain, and they were fighting Hannibal, who had organized a smaller army. Battle of Cumae. How do you say the place? And the Romans lost 60,000 troops in a day. It was a really horrifying thing, but it puts things in perspective. Hi, Giuliano Adorno. From Florida. You're amazing. Can I have a hug? That's very impractical at the moment. Are you wearing green right now? Because if you are, I'm dead right now. I am wearing green. You're so dead. Show us more cow pics. No, I'm hoarding them. I'm hoarding them all. I'm not going to share them with any of you. I'm going to keep them for myself. No, that's not true. I'm not going to do that. Can you actually use an arrow? Sure can. It turns out shooting arrows is a lot easier than you think, and they're very scary. Because they're dangerous. Go as a scary cow. No such thing. What's your favorite animal? What a ridiculous question. Has Emerald taught you any Spanish? I've taught her a bunch of Spanish. She barely spoke before she met me, and now she speaks almost fluent, which is really incredible. Now, I've never worn cologne. I did. I had cologne. I think my aunt got me cologne once, and I wore it for a while, but I don't know what to do with it. If you are into photography or you like taking photos, I suggest getting a nice camera because it really is really cool. You learn a lot. I'm still learning. I'm very basic. I just sort of zoom in and take photos of animals' faces. Matt, your hair. What happened to it? It's there, right? I can tell it's he's looking. I can look in the thing. I got an image here of my face. Do you want to steal Alberto's kitten? Maybe. One of you had a funny question. Okay. Can you be my parabatide, please? I could, but there's like a whole process, and we gotta take vows. We gotta work together, and then we're bound. And I don't know about your health. Are you healthy? Because if you die, that would be problematic.
Okay, so first person to ask a question. Uh-oh, you're in school? You should not have your phone in school. I get detention, I blame you guys. I haven't had my muffin yet, Matt. Are you from China? No. Uh-oh, our boss joined. Or one of our boss ladies just joined the chat.
Oh, wow.
That's
yes.
Trouble. She's gonna monitor what we're doing. What do you think happens to Sizzy next season? Well,
I think it's gonna be.
I want more Clary Alec, bro TP. I don't know what that means.
Me neither. Okay. I want deleted scenes too. I wonder if they can do that.
Yeah, I'm sure they have them. They're never gonna release them to you guys because they're very racy and inappropriate, and we can't be releasing things like that to the public.
No, say that again.
It was like
it's kind of like that, like.
Oh, baby pig or baby cow? Both are good options. I don't know. I like about the Shadow World is that it's just one big happy family, and you know nothing ever really goes wrong. There's not a lot of conflict, and everyone seems like they're just sort of enjoying their lives.
What show are you watching?
I love ice cream. That's okay. Guys, do you ship Malik? I mean, what?
No,
we all hate Malik, yeah, as much as you guys do.
Either Clary or Alec or Magnus. Yeah, Magnus. Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. So now we have to come to Finland, Germany, the UK,
hola,
Italy, South Jersey. So if nobody has anything to talk about, I'm going to start talking about things. I left my pumpkin at home today, and I bought this pumpkin for the sole purpose of bringing it here and then carving it. And I forgot it. Now it's 3 days in a row that I've forgotten it. Yeah, so back to my pumpkin, which I feel like is really important. Alec wouldn't forget his pumpkin at home 3 days in a row. And it's been a real difficult thing for me to deal with. The loss of this pumpkin. It's like, it's actually like a perfect pumpkin. It's it's so little and round, but it's like the right shape, like the shape. It's just like how like a stereotypical pumpkin would look.
What is your favorite food?
I like a lot of things. Right now I'm thinking about pumpkins. I like pumpkin seeds. You lay them out, you put them on a pan, you heat them with some salt, maybe some curry. It's real good. It's real good, I'm telling you.
Let's talk about pumpkins.
What will you be for Halloween? I'm gonna be a big pumpkin. I've done it before. I'll do it again. I mean, I run around outside for about, you know, 2-3 hours a day. I play in the dirt, climb trees, frolic through rivers, head over to a pumpkin patch, maybe steal a pumpkin, bring a pumpkin home, and remember to bring it home. Unlike today. Thank you, Keely. You get it. You see? You're gonna bring me many pumpkins. That's all I've been wanting. Pumpkins. You have a cat called Pumpkin. Well, tell her to get her butt over here because I've been missing any kind of pumpkin will do, including a cat named Pumpkin. It better be red or orange. What are you disguising as this Halloween? I like that, disguising. I'm gonna call it disguise. I'm not gonna call it a costume. I'm gonna disguise as a pumpkin. Probably.